Hello, my name is Bill and welcome to Mind Your Crypto. Today I have Matic Network Polygon Daily Update, a buying opportunity guys, but with some conditions going on. I will explain later what I mean. You need to set your profit target. We will discuss everything with every detail. If you like the content, please hit the like button, subscribe, hit the bell button and share guys. Of course, I have the Telegram group chat on the description down below where you can join in and we discuss many more things about the crypto space. And not only, all right? So here we are, guys. I believe we are having a buying opportunity right here, and we will explain with every details. And we lost now the 0.618. So how do we have a buying opportunity? We will explain later. Right now, for a more macro, we might go down. We might go further down because Bitcoin will go down to 27,000 USDT. According to my opinion, it has more room to correct. But we have some major resistance levels. For example, here, guys, we have our first major resistance level. And if I draw, guys, actually, here it is the first resistance. Secondly, we have 1.59. And of course, right now, the 1.39 became our support level, which was previously support level, became a resistance level. So we need to stay focused here and we need to see if we can achieve these price targets, right? Can we achieve these price targets? Can we go upwards from now here, or we are going all the way downwards? Let's see now the MACD. The MACD, we can tell something, guys. Because on the MACD, you can see we are going up, we are going down, but we are going horizontal. We are having a horizontal move, and we can't decide if we are having a buying opportunity here, or if we are going upwards, of course, or if we are going downwards, right? The most probable scenario here is to go a little bit upwards, but then again, we will fall down, right? The most probable scenario is that, but let's see what we have done. Right now, we can't decide whether we will go upwards or downwards according to the MACD in the 4-hour frame. Let's go to Matic against USDT, guys, on the 4-hour frame. You can see the RSI is not near, is actually near the 30, but not in an oversold situation, while the commodity channel index on the 4-hour frame is in an oversold situation. What we are hoping for is to go back inside and of course surpass this target right here, this resistance level, because we want to make higher lows. Higher lows, guys, it is very important for now if we want to have a swing high to make higher lows. Same for the RSI. We don't want to stop here, for example, guys. We want to start make higher low pattern and of course start going above this target, start making a higher low, higher high pattern. It is very crucial for the RSI and for the commodity channel index. Right now, for the SSL channel, guys, this indicator that tells us when to buy or when not to buy, when the red line is above the green line, we don't have a buying opportunity. However, right now, we might have. Let's go to Matic against USDT, guys, in the daily frame. You can see here the MACD is going down. Okay, it doesn't look good. For example, doesn't look so good. But what do we have here, guys? We have here the Matic approaching the bottom line of the Bollinger Bands, right? We have here the Komodo Channel Index being a little bit in an oversold situation. We have here the RSI going down, but we have more room to grow according to the RSI. First of all, though, you are looking at the commodity channel index, okay? So therefore, guys, we are having a downtrend on the MACD, and you will realize that we are on a very huge downtrend. So how can we recover from it? I believe we will have a swing high. However, this doesn't mean that we will be going to all-time highs, right? Don't get confused with that. I'm just saying we will have a swing high. Let's go to Matic against Bitcoin, guys, to see some pretty little things here. First of all, we are still in an oversold situation. This thing will change. This thing can't stay here for long, all right? We will be going upwards against Bitcoin. Same here with the commodity channel index, guys. We will be going upwards against Bitcoin. We are in an oversold situation right now. And for the MACD, we will have a bullish recross here, but eventually we might get past above this target right here, which we want. So, Matic against Bitcoin in the daily frame, guys. And in the daily frame, we stand in an oversold situation according to the Komodo Channel Index. The MACD doesn't look good as in the USDT, guys. And of course, right now, I will just remove the drawings I don't need. And for the RSI, we can correct more, okay? So, in my opinion, guys, what you should be looking for is when both of these indexes are below their limits. But if you want to be more certain if both of these indexes are below their normal limits, guys, for example, below 30 for the RSI and below minus 100 for the commodity channel index, then we are absolutely are heading upwards in the next few days. For now, because the commodity channel index is below minus 100, we will have a swing high soon. On the daily frame, you can see we are in an oversold situation in everything. We are in an oversold situation in everything. But the bad thing here is that we lost the 200 EMA support level and we lost the 0.618. So even if we have, guys, a swing high, even if we have a swing high, then we won't be able to go upwards to our previous highs. I believe this was a little bit too risky to do. And of course, right now that we lost some major support levels, it is not so easy to climb back to our previous highs for Matic, right? So let's go to Matic against USDT, guys, in the 4-hour frame. We have a buying opportunity. We have a buying opportunity because commodity channel index below minus 100. Matic against Bitcoin, guys, in an oversold situation, the 4-hour frame, but not only in the daily frame as well, we are going down. So we are having a buying opportunity. But what should you do? I would suggest you, if you buy right now, then go for a 10% price target. For example, around here, right? Around here, you can go for a 10% price target. If we fall a little bit more, for example, you buy here, let's say you buy here, guys, and we fall down a little bit more, then you should just wait for the 10%, right? You should just wait here for the 10%. Of course, we will have this pump up soon, but the point is here to wait a little bit. If you want to buy, you can buy and wait a little bit till you have the swing trade, okay? I'm not saying that in the next few hours, we will be going upwards for sure. I'm just saying in the next few days, we will be going upwards for sure, all right? And so you can swing trade. However, this doesn't mean that we are going to previous highs. We won't go to previous highs. We will stay below the previous highs eventually, even below the 1.72. I don't think how fast we can go to the 72. And you can see now that we might have formed here a double bottom and we are going upwards all the way. So right now, what I would do, what I would suggest you to do is to have a swing trade of 10%. Of course, this is not a financial advice, and of course, you are taking a risk right here, because I believe Bitcoin will, after the swing high that it has done right here, Bitcoin will fall down to 27,000 USDT. Therefore, this is only if you want to have a swing high, right? A buying opportunity right now, but you need to set your profit target. If you don't set your profit target, don't blame me afterwards, right? Because I told you multiple times that we are going upwards, but not into previous all-time highs. I'm not saying that we are having a buying opportunity for the next few months. I'm just saying we are having a buying opportunity if you want to sit and trade and take a 10% profit target, right? So for me, Matic will grow upwards eventually as many other altcoins, right? So if I go to the daily frame, guys, you will see that we are beyond the minus 100. We are going into an oversold situation. When this happens, we might go a little bit further down, but we will eventually go upwards, right? So if you buy here, for example, guys, and we go further down, do not panic. You shouldn't panic. We will be going upwards soon. And the reason is here where we can go. I think we can go to 1.48. Yes, I think we can retest the 1.48, especially if we can break a little bit above the 20-day EMA, which we will on the 4-hour frame, but especially in the 50-day EMA, we can break the resistance on the 50-day EMA, then it's all good. We can retest some previous highs. It is very, very difficult to retest the 1.72 for now, but we are having a buying opportunity. You know, I want to be on point with you. You know, I don't want to mess around. And that's what I believe for now, because you cannot, if you don't want, you don't want to follow this advice, then it's all good, guys. You can do whatever you want, because you might not be a swing trader. You might want to just invest for the mid-long term. So right here, if you want it for the mid-long term, I would suggest you to wait, not to invest right now all your money. If you want to invest some of your money, it is okay. But as we do deep down, guys, you want to invest more and more. All right. So you have to wait a little bit if you want for the long term. But if you want for the short term, guys, in the next days, then I suggest you here that this would be a good buying opportunity. I suggest you to do that because we will go upwards and you can take around 10% profit target. That's what I believe. And guys, that's what I think, that's what I would do personally. But if you don't want to do that, then it's all fine. I can understand this, even though this is not a financial advice, right? So Bitcoin, guys, where is Bitcoin heading? Right now, we are looking forward to go to 39,500 USDT, right? We want to go there, but eventually will we go? We hope to go, but we will see about that. Right now, we are in a moment where we can hit the 39,000 USDT. Afterwards, if we go and make this a support level, we can eventually go even further above, right? But we have to be careful because you know my position in here. We are going to 27,000 USDT. Even if we have the swing high, we will fall down. This is my opinion, guys, an honest opinion about things that are going here. On the daily frame, we are having a swing high here on the MACD. You can see we are going upwards all the way. This is good. This looks good. The bullish recross here looked good, but we have some room to grow and we need to stay calm, guys, and we don't want to panic. So therefore, that's my opinion, guys. A buying opportunity. I will say it clearly and loud so you can understand. A buying opportunity with a profit target set around 10%. This is my opinion. If you don't want to follow it, it's all fine. If you want to buy for the long term, I would suggest you to wait a little bit and wait here before you buy anything because we lost major support levels. We are going down. We are having lower highs, lower lows. And in general, much against Bitcoin, even though now we are having a buying opportunity and we might see a reversal to the trend, it doesn't look so good for the next hours, especially if we lose this support level right here, guys. This will be horrible. This will be horrible and we will go all the way down, right? So we have to be careful though. And of course, guys, if you like the content, please don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, hit the bell button and share. Thank you for watching. Have a fantastic day wherever you are. And of course, see you soon with many, many more videos. Bye.